Bhaktacharan Das, Member of Parliament in the Lok Sabha and National Spokesperson of the Congress Party. Satyapal Jain, in charge of the legal cell of the BJP. Gaurav Bhatia, head of the legal wing of the Samajwadi Party. Atul Kumar Anjan of the Communist Party of India. Naresh Kumar Gujral of the Shiromani Akali Dal. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, you know, isn't it becoming very embarrassing for the Congress Party with all these details coming out about Mr. Pawan Kumar Bansal and his family's fortunes, the links between him, his chartered accountant, etc.? Why are you keeping him in the ministry? Is propriety dead within the government? Does propriety not matter?
It is true that some things are coming out against him. But it has to be established, and there would be appropriate action at the appropriate time.
I have a piece of paper which proves that he took an unsecured loan from a company, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, in which a company in which his family members are involved, which in turn got loans from Canara Bank. Director of Canara Bank is his chartered accountant. So what you understand what I'm saying, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, that this is the use of influence to get money going around in circles. I have a paper, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das. The name of Pawan Kumar Bansal is mentioned in this paper. We are the first channel to expose this today. Can you continue to defend Mr. Bansal?
No, I am not defending anyone's misdeed. But the question is that it is his personal thing, what he has done with his relations.
He's a minister.
Like to comment on that.
But he is a minister in your government.
He is a minister, no doubt, and the CBI is investigating very fast. And according to
Mr. Das, can somebody who used to hold the position of deputy minister or junior minister for finance use his clout to appoint his chartered accountant as a director in a public sector company, and then that public sector company 4 months after that gives huge amounts, including 23 crores in one loan transaction, to his family firm, and then the family firm advances, Mr. Satyapal Jain, please note with interest, that family firm gives an unsecured loan to Pawan Kumar Bansal. You understand what I'm saying? So you know what I'm saying? Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, the minister, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, you see, I want to ask you a question. The minister's chartered accountant becomes a director. He makes the family of the minister extremely rich. The family of the minister gives a few lakh rupees to the minister himself as an unsecured loan at 3%. 3%, by the way, which bank gives loans at 3%, sir?
Arnab, this is what I am hearing from you, so I can't comment on this.
Sir, but if this is true, then should he resign? After what we have put out...
The other part of the allegation that the CBI has taken up, so on that issue, I can say that whatever CBI is doing, very faster they are doing, and whatever findings would be there would be appropriate action.
Sir, the CBI is only looking at one angle. Satyapal Jain, let me get you in the Central Bureau of Investigation. Is only looking at the angle of the sale of jobs.
There can be many more issues, Arnab. There can be many more issues.
Such as?
But law is not blind. Law would have to take action on anybody, whosoever it may be.
But that is precisely what I'm saying. Let's get Satyapal Jain in. Mr. Satyapal Jain.
I'm really surprised at the innocence of my learned colleague who is talking on behalf of the Congress Party. The facts, so far as Mr. Pawan Bansal's case is concerned, are very, very clear. One may draw his inference of his own liking, as Mr. My learned friend is doing just now. This Sunil Kumar Gupta is a chartered accountant. He was appointed as the auditor of this concern of this Theon Pharmaceutical Limited, which contains the Mrs. Madhu Bansal, wife of Mr. Pawan Kumar Bansal, his son Manish Bansal, who is an advocate, his another son, and Mr. Amit Bansal. And the wife of Mr. Pawan Bansal's son is also a director in this company. The company appoints Mr. Sunil Gupta as its auditor formally by passing a resolution. Then when Mr. Pawan Bansal becomes Minister of State in the Ministry of Finance and he is given the charge of banking, which is one of the departments of the Finance Ministry, he appoints a few people as directors on various banks, which includes the appointment of Mr. Sunil Kumar Gupta as a director of the Canara Bank. And after becoming the Canara Bank director, the Canara becomes so nice and gentle to the minister and his concerns and starts giving them loans. And in turn, these concerns also start giving loans to the ministry and other people. I have a copy of the return filed by Mr. Pawan Kumar Bansal as a minister before the Prime Minister on 31st of August, and in which he says, my spouse, Mrs. Madhu Bansal, received an amount of rupees 16 lakhs
okay.
as dividend for the year 2009-10.
No, I have one more angle.
One more fact.
I want to now expose a second fact. Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, please pay attention. The second fact I have is that in what appears to be a quid pro quo, Sunil Gupta, who is the minister's chartered accountant, also recommends the minister's nephew, called Vikram Bansal, as an independent director on the board of a large insurance joint venture it set up with the Oriental Bank of Commerce and HSBC Insurance Holdings.
Yes.
Am I correct? So the question here is, sir, please tell me honestly, this is a cozy club. This is a cozy club of quid pro quo, which is underway.
Chartered accountant and this Canara Bank thing, just I am hearing from your side now. So at this moment, spontaneously, I can't say you anything.
Sir, Canara Banks own 51% stake in the insurance joint venture. Pawan Kumar Bansal.
That I know about the appointment of this director of the Canara Bank or the financing, making finance by his relation. I am not aware.
No. What is the minister's nephew say? Minister's nephew says, I am a BCom honors LLB from Punjab University. So I have been appointed for my qualifications. I am asking you, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, please tell me, sir. How many BCom honors LLBs? How many BCom honors LLBs are appointed independent directors in large insurance joint venture?
Listen, I consider the minister's nephew as a different entity than the minister, and whatever he has done, the CBI has taken him into task. So I have nothing to say on this.
How can they be different entities? Vikram Bansal, Amit Bansal, and Sunil Gupta.
See,
three people are all directors of a company owned by Amit Bansal, Bansi Ronak Group Limited.
Arnab, on the different entity where the police, the CBI has already acted.
Okay.
I won't like to comment on those people.
Fine. I have more facts. I haven't finished my interrogation on this subject. I want to now get it. This is very, you're going to have to open it up. Atul Kumar Ranjan, the question here tonight is of propriety. What would you say to our Congress representative tonight? You know, who's being quite diffident to the facts that I'm bringing to his attention.
The Congress representative is a senior member of the Congress party. He had been the minister also. He knows the limitations of minister. He knows how the ministers operate. Unfortunately, one after other, the facts which you, Arnabji, you are revealing, it's like that the skeleton or more skeletons are supposed to come from their, you say, wardrobe. Yes. I don't understand this from the skeletons from cupboard, where they will land. And keeping in view all the facts which are being, you see, put forth in this show, I am sure that some of the very senior people of the Congress party, those who are very much worried about the fate of the Congress party,
they are not, Mr. Atul Kumar Ranjan, you are mistaken.
The stock response
from the Congress party is that there is an ongoing CBI investigation. Naresh Kumar Gujral, with all these details coming out about the financial conflict of interest, will that stock response work? Because the CBI is only investigating sale of jobs. This is not only about sale of jobs now.
Arnab, you are giving some startling facts today. I hope they are facts. But if all this is true, I think it's high time the Congress party, the Honorable Minister and the Prime Minister, they should cut their losses, and temporarily he can be asked to step down. And if the CBI finds that all this is unfounded, he can come back again. But this is definitely damaging the image of the government.
No.
And not just the image of the government, but the image of the country as well.
No, Mr. Gujral, the worrying part is this. I'm coming to Mr. Satyapal Jain. Let's get everyone in. Gaurav Bhatia, the worrying part is that what politicians are telling some of our journalists, including me, is that the reason we are not acting against Pawan Kumar Bansal is because if we expose his family fortunes, then a lot of family fortunes of other politicians will also be exposed. And they say it is a fact. They say it is a fact in India today that a politician does not do any corruption himself. His hand is often clean, but he uses his influence to make his entire family quite rich. And the money is often routed directly or indirectly through the family members. No, I think it's time to expose it. Don't you think, Gaurav Bhatia?
Arnab,
I will be.
Arnab, the most important
point
is that not whether the Congress is asking Mr. Pawan Bansal to step down or not, because that is Congress's internal business and Congress would probably be booted out for that in the next general election. But the more worrisome part is that a powerful minister continues to be a minister, and how would the CBI investigate fairly when he is occupying such an important position? Because we should not forget that the investigation revolves around documents related to the railway ministry, appointments related to the railway ministry. The officers who have been given plum postings have to be interrogated, who are under the control and supervision of the railway minister. Then how can we expect a fair investigation? And therefore, propriety demands, and otherwise also for the sake of fairness and free and transparent investigation, it is imperative upon the minister to resign and let a fair investigation be conducted. And this is the more worrisome part.
No, but I must argue on fact. The fact also is this. Now, Bhaktacharan Das, let me come back to you. It was only after Sunil Gupta, and I want to explain this. Sunil Gupta is the minister's chartered accountant. He is nominated by the minister as a government director on the board of the state-run Canara Bank. After the minister's chartered accountant becomes a director of Canara Bank, Canara Bank starts becoming the chief or sole lender to firms owned by Amit Bansal and Vijay Singla. Mr. Bhaktacharan Das,
yes,
tomorrow,
Mr.
I'm just asking you, tomorrow...
I understand how
serious this is, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das. It's very serious now.
Yes, sir. I'm also too serious than you. Mr. Arnab, I understand your concern, and debate you are making, it is the fourth pillar of the Constitution, I think, and people are watching. And you have presented whatever the materials you have before you, and the way I am to reply in the present circumstance, in this subject especially, I have not understood about this thing. Only I am hearing from you and understanding.
No.
So instant reply on this matter.
I understand.
It would be not decent for me to.
No, I understand. You don't have to. But may I ask you a broader question, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das? You see,
please.
It's my duty as a journalist to put the facts out. The fact is also that Sunil Gupta, who is the minister's chartered accountant, is not just auditor of Amit Bansal's firms, he also audits Vijay Singla's firms. Vijay Singla gets 25 crores from Canara Bank in a period when there is no significant business activity by his firm, Mirage Infra Limited. In other words, you know, people are asking that in this country there are so many deserving people, Mr. Bhaktacharan Das, so many deserving entrepreneurs, so many young people in this country who are there in lines outside public sector banks saying, please give me 10 lakh rupee loan, give me 15 lakh rupee loan, let me start a small enterprise, let me open a pawn shop, let me open a small warehouse. Those people don't get loans. But this same company,
Arnab, you are an intelligent and very learned person, so far as I know about you.